Hi, I'm Bharat Puri. I work for Pidilite. I run the company. My one piece of advice is love what you're doing. Remember, we're never going to love all of what we're doing. If largely you're enjoying what you're doing, you're enjoying the people you're working with, and every morning you get up with a spring in your step, wanting to go somewhere, which is your office, then that's the place for you. In my view, a career is a set of test matches. It's not a T20 match, it's not a one-day international. And in a test match, in every assignment, you play yourself in, you duck under some of the bouncers, you let something go outside the off stump, you get hit a few times. Don't quit just because you've hit twice. Don't quit because you feel, hey, this pitch is not working well for me. If you're learning, if you're enjoying, and if you're liking the people you're working with, that's the place you should enjoy yourself. I've always maintained that smartness is overrated. In the end, it is about attitude and it is about effort. I must have seen probably over 1,000 young managers in my long career. All of them are uniformly smart. In the end, you don't need to be a rocket scientist to sell glue or chocolate or paint. What you require is the right attitude. And when I say right attitude, what people impress me are those who have this learning, listening, can-do attitude. The second is effort. A lot of time, you have to dig yourself in and dig deep because it's required. At one point of time in my career, we had a crisis, the famous Cadbury crisis. The team members who really stood out were the ones who said, listen, this is my problem and I need to solve it. It was not, hey, listen, the organization has a problem, but I have a 9-to-5 job. It was, this is my life problem and I need to solve it. And therefore, attitude and effort is something I would commend wholeheartedly. Don't overdo the smartness piece. I think that's been a great learning. And the third one is, don't take yourself too seriously. You're not averting nuclear war. You're not solving world hunger. At times, I get really worried when people seem to think that this is the be-all and end-all of everything. It's very important to be balanced, see things in perspective, and remember that in the end, it's important to enjoy what you're doing, to have a spring in your step, overcome the job, don't let the job overcome you. When I read The Catalyst, it really resonated. In fact, many things resonated with me, and therefore picking up two or three is not an easy task. The first one clearly is this one about preparing for the second half and therefore making sure you grow in the first half. A lot of us spend so much time thinking about our next assignment that we forget the assignment that we're doing. Using my test match analogy, when you're playing one test match, concentrate on the ball there, please. Don't worry about how much you'll score in the next one. The second thing that really resonated with me from the book was the one about values. In the end, management is a lot about leadership. We don't listen to what leaders say. We see what they do. And therefore, living values, being clear what you stand for, in my view, any leader is about authenticity, he's about trust, and he's about walking the talk. And that really resonated with me when he talks about, you know, bosses and mentors and the right leaders. Again, something I thoroughly endorse and something that I thoroughly believe in. The other one, which of course, you know, I also found really interesting as far as the book was concerned, was this whole converting time to experience. It's good to play yourself in, but you have to look at the runs on the board. It's not the time that you spent in the crease, it's the runs that you scored. A lot of times I have fellows coming and telling me, I've spent 2 years in my assignment, what's my next one? I said, listen, tell me what you've learned and what you've contributed in this assignment. And again, this book brings it out very well. I can use even some of those lessons now. For example, I just love the analogy about the rocks in the sand. Which are the big rocks in your life? Make sure you first put the rocks in the jar. You can put as much sand as you want later. Get the rocks right. The rocks are your family, the rocks are the big ones at work, the rocks are not the small things to worry about. I, of course, know young Molly now for over 25 years. We've worked together across three organizations. I was his first boss, so you can blame me for many things. You know, Molly came to me and told me, hey, listen, I'm writing a book. I was very keen and very interested to see the end product. And when he came and presented me the catalyst, I must say, I was thoroughly impressed. The book is quintessentially Molly. It is original, it is thought-provoking, it is insightful, and it is Molly. And therefore, if you want to sit back, think a lot, read a little, think a lot, read a little, this is the book for you. I tell you, there is matter worth two or maybe even a little more than two books in this little one book. Remember, leadership is about knowing where you're going and being able to persuade others to go with you. As a leader, when you need to sit back, reflect, introspect, keep this by your side, read a chapter, I thoroughly believe it's something that you will find useful. Go for it.